recruiting had come out different, and he's publicly talked to Mark about it and publicly said that, I don't want to make sure everyone's on the same page. I have nothing but good things to say about my football coach. Has he talked to you directly about making sure you understood where he was coming from on that deal?
Well, he and I talk about stuff like that, but I knew exactly what he was saying. He was taken out of context, and the reason he's apologized is because the world we live in, that's what happens, you know. It never concerned me for a second, because I know him. I've known him a long time, and I know exactly what he thinks, and I know exactly what he expects, and he has a pretty good feel for what I think and I expect.
So he didn't take that as a, hey, stick to you what you know and let me handle recruiting and coach your football.
Me?
Yeah, when you heard what he said.
I've aged and done this so long, not a lot of things bother me anymore. But there wasn't a second when I saw it that I thought that I knew what he was trying to say. He just didn't do a good job of getting the information. I mean, that's the same thing I told him. Because, you know, he was very apologetic, and I said, Coach, I know what you were trying to accomplish. You don't have to worry about me. So, but it's difficult, you know, to say the right thing all the time.
Yeah. So a year ago, I said a little while ago about your disposition, well, part of it was your relationship with the administration. So yours, as good as it's been with those guys.
It hasn't changed.
Yeah.
All that did was instigate enough for people to wonder, but I go back to the same thing. I'll say this again, is that if there's things that need to be discussed on a very high grade, he and I will have discussions. He's a busy person, and I'm busy raising farm animals. So do we see each other every day? No. Chad Weiberg's involved. I can communicate with him, get information, and if coach needs to be involved. But that's everywhere. Most of your I don't know what everybody else does, but I know a lot of places that when I looked into their program, the athletic director and the head coach don't have a lot of conversations. There's assistant athletic directors in charge of football. So Chad and I work on a lot of things, but in the situation with Coach Holder, as soon as I heard it or somebody sent it to me, I knew exactly what was going to happen. But I also knew exactly what he was trying to say. He just doesn't have a way of saying things that fit in the society today where people understand. He's just very, for lack of a better term, old school in his approach.
What was he trying to say?
I think he mentioned James Washington in the article. I honestly didn't read it all. I just got bits and pieces. Well, everybody here knows that he thinks that James Washington's a great player. So he was just trying to say, I'd like to bring some guys in like James. And the fact that James is a two-star anyway. So, you know, it just didn't come together. But I knew exactly what he was trying to say, and it didn't bother me for a second. Not at all. And he and I have talked, in fact, twice in the last week on different things, like what you guys had mentioned. Because I have to have discussions with him when there's a lot of money involved, you know, which is like trying to get blood out of a turnip. But none of that's affected anything. It really hasn't. I mean, I've been doing this too long now. If it did, I would just say, hey, you know what? He thinks what he thinks. I think what I think. I work with President Hargis and Chad, and I don't talk to Holder. I just tell you that because